separating the truth from the lies, coming at you from underneath an undisclosed area's chemtrail sky. You're about to receive the shock treatment. Folks, take a look. I just posted a video last night on my channel, For the Awake, and on Facebook about the crop failure worldwide crop failures. And the big elephant in the sky is the reason. What am I talking about? For those of you who've been fast asleep or still insist on staying in your bubble, head in the sand, cognitive dissonance, I'm talking about the geoengineering, solar radiation management, the stratospheric aerosol injections, the chemtrailing, the manipulation of the weather, the controlling of the weather, folks, on purpose, deluging the Midwest, drying out and zap direct energy the West Coast. You think all this is by accident? And then they're calling for more rain in the Midwest, saying they need more rain. No, they don't. This guy owns a farm. He's about to take a boat out. That's right, a boat to look at his farm, because his farm, a part of his farm, is totally flooded out. Let me ask you a question, folks. Can you plant crops in a flooded farm? Can you? Let me help you out. The answer is no. You can't. Will there be a delay in planting maybe corn and soy and other crops? The answer is yes. So what is that going to mean for the food supply? What does that mean? And I caught Richie from Boston, and this is piggybacking off of my video, but Richie from Boston did one too about this, saying about food shortage. So where is that going to lead us? And will they be just targeting the farms that don't use the Monsanto / Bayer GMO seeds? Are they just targeting them, or is it every farm? Any way you slice, it's going to cause a food shortage. So where are we going to get our crops from that we'd normally grow here? Where are they coming from? What kind of quality would that be? How about them, their prices? Bound to go up? Food shortage? Food scarcity? They can do this with the weather, and they are doing it by controlling the weather, by hammering the skies. Go look up at the skies for once. Those ain't your daddy's skies, folks. Those ain't the skies from yesteryear. Contrail, mon frère, it's not a contrail. I've already gone over this many times. Aluminum, strontium, barium, for starters. Breathing this in, and it's wreaking havoc on the climate. It's called climate engineering. And if you want to call it climate control, you could call it that, because that's what they're doing. The Air Force says it plans on controlling the weather by owning it by 2025. Lyndon B. Johnson said 50 years ago, it lays a predicate for control of the cloud layer, the world's cloud layer, and ultimately, you know, talking about satellites, to control the weather. He who controls the weather controls the world. Well, I don't think they need satellites. They probably need cell towers, HAARP, and a whole lot of chemtrail and a whole lot of geoengineering up there. And it's causing this weather whiplash. So don't be too surprised in the near distant future if there's going to be a big food shortage. Don't be too surprised, because this looks like an ocean to me, or a huge-ass lake. This is someone's farm. And it's happening, and it's accelerating. And then you got these jerk meteorologists out in the Midwest saying, we need more rain. No, you don't. Jackasses. I even said that here in Georgia, when Glenn Burns or some other meteorologist wanted to say
that we need more rain, that we're behind 10 inches. No, we're not. We weren't, because I've seen it. Even as a kid, we just had like days on end of heavy rain. You're going to come back and say, well, we still need more rain. No, we don't. And no, they don't. But this is what they do. So take a look at your skies today. This is an example right here. Those are not contrails. I don't know what part of this people don't get. Those are chemtrails or geoengineering. However you want to phrase it, tomato, tomato. It's not normal, and it's all part of the plan, the agenda to manipulate and control the weather, which is what they're doing. But they're doing a pretty damn lousy job at it, I'll tell you that. Because when you get farms that are flooded out where they can't plant, Houston, we have a problem. Guys, you need to think about it. We're living in some serious times. Serious. You might want to consider storing up some food, prepping. Until next time, you receive the shock treatment. Unbelievable.